I really think I've got it this time. I'm having a go at the alternate history genre. You know, when something in the past happens slightly differently, so everything now is just slightly different but eerily similar. See what you think. Prime Minister Corbyn woke early with the bitter taste of schnapps in his mouth. He had a difficult day ahead. It was the 6th of May, 2023, and he had to be at the Abbey by 10 a.m. It was a big occasion. The coronation of... What? Is that not...? OK, on with the show. Joining me for this quarterfinal are, on my right, Will Chadwick, a maths tutor who got pulled aside at Krakow Airport for having wires in his luggage. Jack Karimi, a Democratic Services officer who's allergic to kiwi fruit. And their captain, Sam Haywood, a science teacher who has over 50 pairs of shoes. All keen charity shoppers, they are the Thrifters. Sam, where did you all source your outfits this evening?
Various places. I love a good charity shop. I think they might have just gone eBay.
Do you have a favourite brand of charity shop, I think you'd be allowed to say?
I'm quite fond of anything that's for dogs or cats.
Yeah. I'm assuming you mean the charity, not the clothes.
Yes.
You are playing tonight on my left. Elizabeth Down, a modern European history student who has two cats named Hamilton and George. Thea Ralph, a history student who was president of the In the Pink a cappella group for 2 years. And their captain, Rachel Young, a classic student who once watered her radishes with acid by accident. Enthusiastic about embroidery, they are the Stitchers. Rachel, many of our contestants here look like they're wearing homemade clothes. I'm hoping you guys are the real thing. You've got this deep in the series and I've never asked. Are these things you've sewn?
Of all the episodes to ask us, I don't think we are this time round.
I think this is one of the only times we're not.
I dyed this top green myself, but it's not the same level as Thea's embroidered shirt.
I had an embroidered shirt about 2 episodes
ago.
Yeah,
or like Lizzie's handmade clothes, but not this one.
What eco-friendly dressers all these teams are, and me too, because last night, as usual, I slept in this. Thrifters, you'll be going first. Please choose an Egyptian hieroglyph.
Water, please.
Water will be the first question of this match, and it is the picture question. Okay. What connects these lovely images? Here's the first.
Kind of bird eye. It's sort of a seabird. Yeah, I think I've got next. Next, please. Like birds have other animals in the name, maybe. Next, please. Oyster catcher, I think. Yeah, so shall we go for it? I'll try to go because it could all be birds that have another animal. Okay, next, please. Woodpecker. Are they all peckers? I don't know.
1 second.
Let's just try. They're all birds that have another animal in their name.
Not it, I'm afraid. Stitches, do you want to have a go for a bonus point?
We think they're all named after what they do.
They are named after what they do. Which birds did you recognise?
So there's a kingfisher, number two, and a woodpecker, the fourth one.
Yeah, the one with the orange and blue colouring, it's coloured like a kingfisher. It's actually a bee-eater.
Oh.
The first one is a hen harrier, and that little black and white chap is an oyster catcher. So well done, you get the bonus point. And what would you like for your own question?
Horned viper, please.
Horned viper. What would connect these clues? Here's the first.
Is that like a physics thing? Is there a moon? I don't know what it counts.
I don't know what it counts either.
I think it's physics.
Next one.
Next, please. Is that a big book?
like a big heavy book.
Next, please.
Is that lint?
German.
From Switzerland or Germany.
Do we want another one?
I think we definitely
want. Next, please. Named after the Swiss people. I don't know if you can say that. They're all named after Swiss people.
They are not all named after Swiss people, so a bonus chance for you now, Thrifters.
So the name in each thing is the opposite of what it should be, so it should be Geiger Mutt, so it should be Geiger Counter, and is it the Bechdel test instead of the Wallace test?
What do you mean by the opposite?
I assume Muller was some sort of partner of Geiger and sort of created Geiger the Geiger Counter.
That's what it is. Yeah. Opposites is a slightly strange way of putting it, so I had to check you knew the connection. Yes, there are partnerships. Yeah. Where the things in question are more commonly known by the name of the other partner, but the Geiger-Müller counter was come up with by that partnership, and originally Carter's Anatomy of the Human Body was also
Grey's Anatomy.
Grey's Anatomy, and I think Carter was the illustrator. He remains the illustrator, but more people call it Grey's Anatomy. Lindt and Sprungly chocolate is known as Lindt. And the Wallace Bechdel test. Yeah. Yes, the American cartoonist Alison Bechdel, her name stayed on it, and Wallace has rather slipped away. Well done. What would you like for yourself?
Can we go Twisted Flax, please?
Yes, you can. What is the connection between these clues? Here's the first.
So a neighbouring. So if Parham was Earl, so you're changing like one word for a similar thing, high rank or something.
Possibly.
Yeah, next, please.
What
do you think? It's a funeral. So wake and funeral, so it's followed by funeral. Maybe something to do with his funeral. It's something. Yeah. Next, please.
I think that's the best one. That would be the thing before.
Next, please.
2 seconds.
Right. OK. So I think it's something to do with if you were to do the thing, it would be a higher rank. So if Baron's Court were inspired, it'd be at Earl's Court. Instead of it being Finnegan's Wake, it would be Finnegan's Funeral.
The thing before.
It is not okay. to do with ranks, I'm afraid. So bonus opportunities again for you, Stitches.
Is it to do with where the apostrophe goes in the things that they're referring to?
Keep talking.
There isn't an apostrophe in them, but if you put an apostrophe in, they would do this.
That is exactly right. And there's a little clue for you in the last one. AC/DC's Bells, there's a missing apostrophe there, and that is because in the AC/DC track Hell's Bells, there is no apostrophe, but there's an argument that it should have one if the bells are from hell. If they are the bells of hell, it should have that possessive. So if Baron's Court were named after Earl's Court, it should have an apostrophe, because Earl's Court does. Finnegan's Wake, if it is the wake of Finnegan, it would have one. And what's that at clue three?
Is it Howard's End?
Howard's End, the novel. And if it is the Howard's End, you might put an apostrophe after the S, but it has none. What would you like for your own question?
Eye of Horus, please.
Eye of Horus. It's the music question. What do they have in common? Here's the first. Will you ever
learn to love? Next, please. Oh, this is Walk This Way, but it's Run DMC version.
Oh, yeah.
But it was originally Aerosmith, right?
Okay, yeah.
Next one. Next, please. Why you look so sad? The tears are in your eyes. Come on and come to me. Next, please. Oh, is it? Like, was it Van Halen? So it's originally by rock bands.
Yeah.
We think these are all covers of songs originally by rock bands.
You've got to tell me something else.
What were the ones we knew? Is it Van Halen? Is it all? No.
Yeah.
I think you don't know. So, bonus opportunity for you, Thrifters.
We'll salivate on this one.
Go on. Well, covered by Girls Aloud.
I mean, the phrase "will salivating" at this one. I think whether that passes the Bechdel test, I'm not quite sure. That was a little Christmas gift for you there, Will. I think you mean right in Will's wheelhouse of knowledge. Yes. What did we hear, Will? Perhaps you can tell me.
Jump by the Pointer Sisters. Mm-hmm. See the Day was the first track.
Yeah, DC Lee.
I've totally forgotten what else.
I'll Stand By You, the Pretenders. And now, all three of those, we played the originals. We did not play the original of the second piece, Walk This Way. We played a later release because Aerosmith brought it out again with Run DMC, and the cover was Girls Aloud and the Sugar Babes. So they were sort of covering the combined version. Last chance this round to get points on your own question. Which one will it be?
Two reads, please.
Two reads it is. What is the connection between these clues? Here's the first.
Next, please. So, Carol, is that four plus something divided by?
Something to do with
15 if we're going to. Next, please. That's 16. I don't know what this is. Do you want next?
Unless that could be Quince, that first one, couldn't it?
Oh, yeah, should we go with that?
Yeah.
Okay, so when you work out the sum in that language, go on.
The only one I'm really basing this on is the Karanti Cinco. I think that works out as Quince or Quince, I'm not sure how you pronounce it, which is a fruit. Yeah. So if you work these mathematical sums out in the languages, they'll give you a word
that means,
that means the answer.
You've got it. That is exactly right. That is the Spanish for 45 divided by 3, which would be 15 quints of fruit. Can you do the other sums?
The last one is 8 times 2 is says, so 16 for C's.
Exactly so. Let's have a look at clue 4.
Elf.
Sieben plus vier makes elf a Christmas worker. And the first one?
It looks Hungarian.
Well done. Hit takeaway edge, I think, is 7 takeaway 1 makes, well, hat is how you'd write it, but I think you pronounce it hot. I mean, I know about 4 things in Hungarian and most of them are numbers, but I'm sure I've said them all wrong. But 7 takeaway 1 would be 6. Well done. Not least for getting your own points. So your turn now, Stitches, to see if you can get the lion question. What connects these clues? Here's the first.
Next, please.
Like a monster, I think, maybe. I don't know. Not something like a gap, isn't it?
Yeah.
Your next one.
Next, please. So that makes you forget.
Oh, so they're all things
that
you forget.
Oh, I think that might be from that film where you forget things. I think it's Eternal Sunshine.
Yes.
These all make you forget.
Very well done. The last clue would be Superman's kiss. What can you tell me about the clues we're looking at?
So I know Lethe is one of the rivers in the Greek underworld, and if you drink its water, you like forget the life you've just been living.
Precisely.
We think the second one might be Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind.
Exactly so. That's a company that can wipe your mind for you. Meng Po soup, that's the goddess of forgetfulness in Chinese Buddhism, and she would give a soup to allow you to forget your past lives before being reincarnated. And Superman's kiss, that's Superman 2. He kisses Lois Lane at the end and she forgets basically everything that happened in the film. If you could have a kiss that made you forget a film, what film would you pick? For me, it would definitely be The English Patient.
I think the worst film I've ever seen is Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom.
I mean, because you'd assume that would be good, wouldn't you, when you went in?
It says something when a film is so bad that a dinosaur can't save it, so I'd happily forget that one.
That means at the end of round one, the Stitchers have 4 points, the Thrifters have 4 points. On to round 2, the sequence is round. And Thrifters, you'll be going first again. What would you like?
Water, please.
Water. What would be the 4th in this sequence? Here's the first.
Next, please.
That's
where
I want my
team to pull. OK. Well, I don't know what we're doing with that. Next, please. Burning down the house.
Not the right answer. Stitches, do you know?
Yeah, talking book again.
It is not talking book again. Who would you say, Will, is superior musically? Would you say it's Girls Aloud or Stevie Wonder?
Stevie Wonder's probably.
This is a series of Stevie Wonder albums. They called it his golden period because it was all so great. And 4th in this sequence is
Songs in the Key of Life,
of course. Not only a phenomenal set of music, but he remembered the apostrophe in that album title at clue 3. Stitches, what would you like?
Horned Viper, please.
OK. What would come 4th in this sequence? Here's the first.
OK, so there's an arrow in it. Alter, maybe, to repair.
Next, please.
A bonus to a bird.
A bonus and onus.
Yes. So...
Taking away and B.
But how many are we taking away? Oh, yes. Adjust is... Fix.
Yes. So we've got to think of another one.
So then is that right? So bonus, onus. It's what's when you move a D and the meaning changes. Is that what's happening?
Yeah.
So like threats and rage.
Yeah. Okay, let me see.
Threat, an arrow, and then rage.
And why would that be?
Because it's danger becomes anger if you move the D. So there you've got affix goes to fix if you move an A. Bonus goes to onus if you move a B. So then you would move a C to change the meaning and then you move a D.
An almost perfect answer. You will get the point because I want to hear that you remove a D. We went with delegate, power, and develop. So devolve, evolve. To turn a fix into fix, you'd have to take away an F as well, wouldn't you?
Oh, has it got 2 Fs in it?
Yeah, A-F-F-I-X,
See, then fix. That's what I didn't know.
We were thinking adjust repair would be amend and mend.
Sure.
Nevertheless, you worked out you're removing an A, a B, a C. What's hidden in plain sight, do you think?
Covert, overt.
Covert, overt. And we wanted something where you take away a D, for example, danger, anger, or devolve, evolve. Very well done. Thrifters, what would you like?
Twisted flax, please.
Twisted flax. What would come forth in this sequence? Here's the first.
Apart from normal. No, you want to go next? Chrysanthemum, maybe. Next, please. I don't know what it's after. Next, please.
Oh, is it? Is that song? Oh, is it? Oh. Is it a song?
What song?
No, it's not. I thought it was Bingo. Was his name?
No. I don't know.
2 seconds.
It's going well.
Good luck.
Let's go for what they did earlier. All apart from Mum. Mum.
Not the answer, I'm afraid. Stitches, do you know?
Bingo. Bingo.
That's not it. Yeah. This is the opening credits of a children's TV programme, and it is to do with what a group of characters shout. Yeah. And I imagine a group of viewers are shouting at the screen as we speak, all apart from Bluey. Bluey. Back to you, Stitches, for a choice.
Lion, please.
Lion. These are going to be picture clues. What would you expect to see in the fourth picture? Here's the first.
There's a North and South Dakota. That's not helpful.
Yes.
Who's Denzel Washington?
Denzel Washington. A picture of Denzel Washington.
As much as I would love to see a picture of Denzel Washington, the sequence would break if we saw it. Sure. So, Thrifters, another bonus chance.
A picture of John Ford, the film director.
Why would you have that when you could have a picture of handsome Harrison Ford, who everybody wants to see, but anybody whose surname is Ford would be acceptable, and why?
They are US presidents. I don't know who the first one is, but I assume it's Kennedy, then Dakota Johnson, then was it the
Cynthia Nixon?
Cynthia Nixon, and then Harrison Ford.
Exactly, so that's George Kennedy, the actor. So we want to hear the next president after Nixon would be somebody Ford. Well done for the bonus and a choice.
Eye for us, please.
Eye for us. What would come?
No.
Oh. What a treat. You're going to be hearing some clues. What would you expect to hear in fourth place? First one coming in now.
Next, please. Next, please.
2 seconds.
It's all space. That's
yeah, all right then, yeah. Space Oddity.
Not it, I'm afraid. Stitches, do you know?
No, I know. I don't think we know this one.
What did you recognise of what we heard?
Was David Bowie the first one?
Yes.
And then...
What I need is the titles of the tracks. David Bowie and Sorry for This Language, Queen Bitch. The next one, Taylor Swift, Lover.
Yeah. Lover. We know you love her.
Then we had Marco in Child, so we've got Bitch, Lover, Child. What do we want?
Mother.
Something with Mother. Who can think of a song with Mother in the title?
Does your mother know, Abba? Yeah. As well?
I mean, yeah, you understand you're naming what it is you have to sing.
Oh. I can't name any songs with Mother in
there,
sorry.
Oh. The Abba's quite... I genuinely can't think how it goes.
Thank goodness.
And I know what you mean when you give me a flash of that smile. Dum, dum, dum. But girl, you're only a child, exactly. That's because your mother knows, isn't it? I think it is. So, unfortunately, no points there. But there is one question left. It's the two Reese. That'll go to you, Stitches. What would come forth in this sequence? Here's the first.
It might be football or something. It's probably football, isn't it? Shoot, can I have another one? Next, please.
I think it's joining
UEFA or something. Like joining the Euros.
Yeah.
We need to ask something.
Joining.
Could there be new edition? That would be nice. Can we have another one? Next, please.
Right.
I think they're joining, like...
It could be NATO, could be
you. It might be NATO.
It might be NATO.
Because, like, Finland just joined NATO.
Yeah, should we do Finland?
2023.
Yeah, why not?
Okay.
Finland 2023.
Not correct, I'm afraid. Thrifters, last chance of a bonus.
Croatia 2023.
Croatia 2023 is the right answer. What is the sequence?
We think it's when they adopted the euro.
The order is accession to the euro, and next will be Croatia. Well done. That means at the end of round two, the Thrifters have 6 points, the Stitchers have 7. Time for the connecting wall, and Stitchers, it's your turn to go first this time. Please choose lion or water.
Lion, please.
Lion. OK, you have 2.5 minutes to solve the lion wall, starting now.
OK. Idle hands, maybe? Idle...
Laika was the dog.
Laika was a dog, yeah.
Pickles feels like a dog.
Pickles is a dog, is it?
Oh, so maybe dog sound, do you think? Nipper sounds like a dog.
Bouncer. Yeah, Nipper is a dog, it's from the Beano.
OK, so we've got some dogs in there.
Nash, I think it's a baby one's looking
at.
Danny Dyer. There must be maybe names in there.
Yeah, it's like
Donald's maybe.
There's Eric Pickles and Eric.
Okay, Eric Pickles. Oh, so then Eric Carmen,
Trump.
I think. She tries
Eric.
Oh,
yes.
Yeah. Okay, but there are Eric's
so
there.
Eric's in there.
She's tried some Eric's.
Yes.
So it's Eric Pickles, Eric Idol. Eric, there's an Eric Trump.
I think so, but maybe we'll.
Eric Bouncer. Eric Marrow.
Maybe this is going to be Eric.
Yeah.
Okay. Should we do some dogs again?
Do some dogs, yeah.
So it's not Pickles.
It could, yeah.
I think.
Maybe.
This feels like a dog name as well.
Flecky. Yeah. Nature Arts is weird. It could be.
I'm going to put these as dogs. That's not.
This restaurant. Maybe. Is that an animal restaurant?
Maybe.
It might be. So then there might be.
Cafe in
Cafe,
place.
Right, good. So.
Deli in Idol.
Deli, brilliant. And.
It's like bar.
Carmen. Yeah, bar would be good at this stage.
We could just maybe this is keep maybe.
I think we should have keep them. Wait, so which ones do we know? Those ones. Wait,
okay, it's definitely these three.
Okay. So then, okay. Oh, great. Okay.
Bistro.
Got 30 seconds.
Okay,
let's do our Eric's.
Trump, Carmen maybe,
and
Dry. What else could be going on?
Should we just give it
just have a go? What are so we think there's Eric's, we think there's dogs. China. Turquoise. What's turquoise
doing? I'm doing some dogs.
Yeah, fair enough.
10 seconds.
Yeah.
And let's do some Eric's.
Let's do some Eric's again. Okay.
Well, that's it. Time's up and the wall has frozen. But you found a group, so that's 1 point and another if you can tell me what connects face, idol and so on.
These are all anagrams of places you can eat food.
Exactly. Anagrams of cafe, deli, restaurant and a bistro. And you can get points for the connections in the groups you didn't find. So let's resolve the wall. There we go. China, dry and so on.
These can all be follow bone.
That's it. Bone turquoise, a sort of fossilised bone or tooth stained blue used as a gemstone. And the next group, bouncer, Laika and so on.
Are these all famous dogs?
They are famous dogs. Nipper is the one in his master's voice with the... It's Gnipper in the Beano,
right,
I think you're thinking of. And Flocky, very newsy. Flocky is Elon Musk's dog, who Elon Musk at one point declared was the CEO of Twitter.
Ooh.
And I think the dog ran that for some time. And I'll tell you what, really showed. And the last group, Carmen, Dyer and so on.
These all Eric's.
They are all Eric's. Well done. So you found one group, but you gave me all four connections. That is a total of 5 points. Let's bring in their opponents now, give them the other wall and see how they get on. Welcome back, Thrifters. You will have the water wall, 2.5 minutes to try and solve it. Here it is.
Right, OK. Wellington, New Zealand. Hamilton's in New Zealand. Rushton, maybe. Carl, there's going to be a few, isn't there? There's quite a few.
Knave's Glove is an anagram of Volkswagen.
Nice, Volkswagen. So
Fiat. Tesla is Slate.
Nice. Yes.
Mackerel's ran out.
Nice. I'll do it. No, it's a bit of
doing that. All right.
Willie Whitelaw. Who's Willie Whitelaw?
He was kind of Deputy Prime Minister.
Okay, so. Au revoir, au pair.
Oh, yeah.
Right, so let's do that, but I won't put it in yet.
Au contraire.
Au contraire, no
fonds.
Okay. Willie Rushton. Oh, Willie Rushton. Willie. Yeah, Willie Washington.
Are they
Washington.
All Willies?
Yeah,
right.
They're
all Willies.
They're just Willies.
Willies. Willie Thorne.
Willie Nelson.
Yes.
Willie Carson, maybe? Yeah, there we go. Okay. Right, so we've got Au Pair, Au Revoir, Au Contraire, and we think Au Fond.
Yes.
So, there's Gisborne, Wild. Are they all placed in New Zealand?
I think it could just be New Zealand. Yes, I think
Do you want to go
be.
With it?
I think they're
Are
all
we
New
sure?
I think they're all
Let's
in
New
Zealand. I think they're New Zealand.
Let's do it.
Well done. Well played. What about the connections? Knaves, Glow, and so on.
So, well spotted. That anagrams of car companies.
What are those companies?
Go on, Will.
Volkswagen, Fiat, Renault, and Tesla.
That's it. And the next group, Carson, Rushton, and so on.
They're from last night on TV, but they're all Willies.
Well, I mean, you've said it several times, so they'd better be. They are all Willies, and yes, that's right, former Deputy Prime Minister Willie Whitelaw. And the next group, Contraire, and so on.
You can put AU in front of all of them to make Au Pair, Au Contraire, Au Fond, and Au Revoir.
Common French phrases we use in English. Well done. And the last group, Nelson, Hamilton, and so on.
We think they're all places in New Zealand.
They are all in New Zealand. Very well done. So that is the 4 points for the connections as well, and the bonus, it's the maximum of 10 points. Let's have a look at the scores going into the final round. The Stitchers have 12 points, the Thrifters have 16. Time now for the missing vowels round, so fingers on buzzers, please, teams. I can tell you that the first group of disguise clues are all Andy Warhol's Campbell's soup cans from 1962. Thrifters?
Green pea.
Yes, it is. Thrifters?
Cheddar cheese.
Delicious. Thrifters?
Onion.
Yes, it is. Stitches?
Cream of asparagus.
Well done. Next category. Works by Graham Greene merged with songs. Thrifters.
Brighton Rock Around the Clock.
That's it. I'll give you this one. Too late, I've started speaking. It's the Third Man Eater. Next clue. Thrifters.
The Power and the Glory of Love.
Well done. Don't know this one, it's slightly ridiculous. England Made Me and Mrs. Jones. Next category, wars and their chroniclers. Stitches?
First World War and Wilfred Owen.
Yes, it is. Thrifters?
Gulf War and Andy McNab.
Right up there next to Wilfred Owen. Stitches?
Peloponnesian War and Thucydides.
Very well done. But no more brilliance because the bell has gone for the end of the quiz. And I can tell you that looking at the final scores, the winners with 22 points and through to the semi-finals are the Thrifters. Very well done, very well played. Stitchers, you finish on 15. What a brilliant team you've been. And I'm sorry I asked you about your clothes just too late. They've always been amazing. Thank you so much for playing. Thanks very much for watching. And I'm so sorry about that bit in round two where Mafanwy in the gallery put up the wrong graphic and I shouted that she was stupid and an idiot because I'm the face of the show and it just undermines me. And why do I have to work with these morons? And, oh, no, wait. I can just bully them into taking that bit out. Forget what I said. We have a lovely atmosphere on this show. Good night.